Welcome back to United Tradesman Academy. Hey guys, look, we got a call out this morning that homeowner's circuit breaker, it's either tripping or it won't reset. And she said it controls the upstairs bedroom or bedrooms, I'm not certain. So it's only gonna be a few reasons why that happens, especially for bedrooms. Typically, you have an overloaded circuit, especially in the winter, they plug in space heaters throughout the house. Or it could be a multiple things, space heater, computer, cell phone charger, you know. So, but if it's like in the bathroom, you know, that's gonna be GFCI controlled. So those are pretty simple to diagnose. So let's go ahead and see if we can find out. Let's go. All right, guys. So this circuit breaker right here controls the bedroom upstairs. That one right there. As you can see, it's one of the arc fault breakers. So what I did right now, I tested the breaker before I removed the wires, and there was no voltage coming off the breaker here, off the terminal screws. So now what I did, I took the wires off, and I put them on a known good circuit breaker. This 15 amp circuit breaker, I put them on that. So I took the original wire, this one right here, that went to this circuit breaker. I removed it so I can do my troubleshoot test. So I hook my hot into the circuit breaker, then I hook my neutral onto the neutral bar right there. So this is one test that we're doing. A very simple, easy test that you can do. It doesn't take no more than 5 minutes to do the test. So I'm waiting for her to go turn her TV on and everything up there to see if it's gonna work. Okay, yes ma'am. All right guys, so this test right here is probably the number one test that I do when I'm diagnosing a bad circuit breaker. This is probably the number one test that I do because it is so quick and easy to diagnose that I don't really, depending on how the client tells me, sometimes I'll go through the house and look around, maybe look for some burned outlets. But in this case, these arc fault circuit breakers, they're notorious for dying prematurely. So I'm gonna wait for her to come back and I'll give y'all the update. I'm sorry, what'd you say, ma'am?
It's on.
Your TV is on also? Okay, yes ma'am, check everything. All right, so we just had confirmation the light is working in there. And now I just told her to go ahead and check everything that was off, because at this point, before I told her to go turn the circuit breaker on, I said, this will let me know that this specific test that I'm doing right here, this will let me know if there's anything else wrong with the circuit other than the circuit breaker. Okay, great. Thank you. Guys, so I'm looking for to see if I have one of those Cutler hammer type breakers. I don't normally carry those because it's more people that have square D or GE panels. So I told her I would check in my van to see if I had a Cutler hammer breaker, a Cutler hammer 15 amp, and it doesn't look like I have one. So probably gonna have to make a run to either Lowe's or Home Depot. So guys, if you're a good technician, these calls like this shouldn't take no more than about really 30 minutes. That's if you have the breaker on you. You know, if I would have had the breaker, you know, I've probably only been here maybe 15 minutes and I've already diagnosed it and looking for the breaker right now. So if I had a breaker, I'll be out of here in, you know, in another 10, 15 minutes, you know. So, but anyway, this is going to probably be about an hour call because I got to run about 10 minutes up the road to get the breaker. But other than that, simple day, life in electrician. Hey guys, comment, like, subscribe. Okay, so let's take this old breaker out. All
let's test it. We'll test the meter here. Volts right there. Yep. Miss Tucker?
Yes, sir.
Can you go check to see if the power's back on upstairs?
Yes, sir.
All right. That should be it for that. Okay. Okay. All right, guys, so very simple process of troubleshooting. That's probably the most used method that I use, you know. Sometimes I gotta take it a little bit further, but it just kind of a case by case basis because depending on how the homeowner, you know, tells me what she observed or what he observed during the circuit breaker tripping or the outlets or power going out, whatever. That's how I make my decision on if I should go further with my troubleshooting or if that method doesn't work. So guys, look, comment, like, subscribe. Thank y'all for getting this channel to where it is. We'll see y'all next time back at United Tradesman Academy.